universal mastery. So today I have a very interesting subject that it is that I am going to be speaking about. This is a personal life experience that I went through that was literally one of the most challenging, scary things that I have ever experienced in my life. But at the same time, it is literally one of the most absolutely transformative things that I have also experienced at the same time. So I'm going to be speaking about my personal experience having dealt with and gone through mold toxicity within the body. I had an experience where I took in toxic mold and it literally caused so many really scary and challenging things to take place in my life. And I'm going to be sharing that entire experience today, how I got the mold in my body, what was the root cause of all of it, what ended up happening to me, what it forced me into, and then how ultimately it transformed my understanding of myself and my perspective on life in general. Okay, so for those of you that are interested in hearing my journey and my experience with mold toxicity, this is absolutely a video that is for you, and I recommend you stay tuned, and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So we are talking about mold toxicity. So I developed mold toxicity within my body in 2020. The reason why I developed mold toxicity is because I was in energetic resonance for the mold to come into my body. So for those of you that don't know, when it comes to any sort of illness as well as any sort of disease, the root cause of it is always going to be energetic, and it's going to be emotional in nature. Repressed emotions lead to unfortunate circumstances. And a lot of the times, those circumstances can come into the form of illness within the body and different forms of mental illness as well. So, as I said, in 2020, there was a specific substance that I was addicted to. It was like one of my go-to unhealthy coping mechanisms. And this substance is called Kratom. Okay, I was introduced to Kratom in 2019 and I started drinking it then. And for a while, as I was drinking Kratom, it sort of was offering itself as some form of a support for my development. It was helping me to better let go, helping me to better open my mind. But then when it hit that next year of 2020, I actually did let go more. I was surrendering. I was stepping more into my authenticity for the first time in a very long time. So the Kratom was no longer necessary. It was no longer needed for my process. And I had a strong intuition that was telling me to let it go. Let go of the Kratom. This is now becoming something that is an addiction and is not good for you. It is offering itself as an escape to what you actually need to be going into. So although I got that intuition, and although I could recognize that within my system, I was still addicted to the Kratom. So I still had this part of me, or these parts of me, that really were relying on it or trying to use it as some form of a protective coping mechanism so that I don't have to, you know, go into deeper emotions that are actually underneath the surface. So with that being said, I didn't listen to my intuition, and I ended up moving from 2019 from Miami to 2020 to Orlando. And I shifted the Kratom place that I went to. So I am now in energetic resonance for something inside of my system, which is a repressed emotion, to physically manifest in some way to then force me to see what it is that I'm repressing. So I was in energetic resonance for mold. And for those of you that don't understand what mold is, mold is nature's organic death cycle process. So when things are ready to pass on in nature and recycle back into earth, that's where mold comes into play, and it initiates that death process or of organic matter, and then it recycles it back into nature. So if you're in energetic resonance for mold, you are resisting dying. You are resisting death. And when I say that, I don't mean physically. I mean emotionally, mentally, to attachments, to unhealthy coping mechanisms, to, you know, parts of yourself that you're refusing to let go of and recognize. So mold only really finds people in a toxic way when you are not letting go and when you're not honoring your true core. So I was in resonance with that. So I went to this Kratom bar over in Orlando, Florida, and I would go there almost every single day. And sure enough, they had a bowl, they had a moldy batch of Kratom. And I was drinking it every single day. So not only am I getting the immunosuppressant aspect of the Kratom itself, but then there's actually mold that I'm taking in orally from the Kratom literally on a daily basis. And obviously as I'm doing this, I have no idea that I'm drinking mold. I don't even understand what mold really is. I don't know how serious of a problem it can be. But towards the end of 2020 of that year, I got to a place where I started noticing symptoms in my gut. My gut was like really feeling strange. Like the best way I can describe it is it felt like there was like a tingling sensation and almost like an expanding sensation in my large colon. And it's hard to explain, but that's what it felt like. And it did not feel good. It felt like something was off. And that manifested towards the end of 2020. And I didn't understand what it was, but I did associate it to the Kratom because I actually tried drinking the Kratom and I ended up throwing it up. And that was my sign that I'm done with Kratom. And that was literally the last time I drank Kratom was in 2020, the time when I threw it up. My body completely rejected it. So me being me, I'm thinking I'm just gonna, you know, focus on what I eat. I'm gonna like start tweaking some things and be a little bit more healthy. I'm gonna start going to the gym and my body's just gonna start healing. So I tried my best. I wasn't perfect. I actually, you know, I got rid of the Kratom and then slowly I started reintroducing alcohol. So I noticed I started drinking alcohol instead, and that was not a good thing to add into the mix. I upped my intake of energy drinks and alcohol, and that was kind of the primary thing that I was using. And that's when I realized, like, I've got this significant addictive behavior in me at that time that I really need to work on. I really need to come to understand it and learn how to release that. And, you know, understand why am I doing this. So my gut just was the way it was. It felt weird. And then I made a decision in 2020 that I was going to move to San Diego, California. So I had made this decision that I wanted to live in San Diego, and I just decided I was going to head out there. So I did. So like at the very end of 2020, the final month, I drove to San Diego, California. Before I went to the hospital to just do a general checkup to make sure my body was okay, because I felt my gut was not feeling okay. And they did a test and they didn't find anything that was wrong with me. And I was like, okay, so I guess things will just heal as time goes on. So I went to California, and this is when I stopped significantly drinking alcohol. I was drinking a lot of caffeine, but I stopped drinking alcohol and I wasn't drinking Kratom. And it was kind of like a commitment that I made for myself. And I wasn't perfect with that either. There was actually a couple times where I did have some alcoholic drinks, but I really watched it and I wasn't doing it often. I was on this path of wanting to heal. So yeah, so I get to San Diego. Long story short, I end up finding an apartment there. Obviously, there's a lot of stuff in between all of this, but I find an apartment. I end up getting into a relationship with someone, which was not a wise decision. I should have used the time for myself to heal and be with myself, but with all this unresolved trauma in my body, I ended up seeking out a relationship. And that was actually a big catalyst for me. But I noticed that my body was showing some signs of improvement in regards to my gut. When I was out in San Diego and I wasn't in a relationship, as soon as I got into a relationship, I noticed my gut healing was not happening anymore. It like stopped. So it actually didn't just stop, but it even got to a point where it started getting worse and worse and worse, very slowly, but it was getting worse. So now I'm in San Diego, I'm in this relationship, it's 2021, and my gut is getting worse and worse and worse, and I'm not understanding what's going on. I'm literally trying to tweak what it is that I'm eating. I'm trying to change certain things. 2022 hits, I start seeing functional doctors. I pay a lot of money to, you know, figure these things out. Crazy, but the functional doctor that I saw, the one that I was working with in the practice, asked me, do you know about mold? And I said, no, I don't really understand it. She said, I want to test you for mold. I was like, okay. And in my mind, I wasn't thinking anything about it. I had no idea mold was even a big problem. To be honest, I didn't really care. I didn't think that would be the issue. And the day that she was going to test me for the mold, she actually ended up leaving the practice. And then a new doctor came in to work with me and they didn't even mention mold. So I was like, all right, like forget about it. It doesn't matter. Like mold's not that big of a deal. So looking back, it's kind of crazy. But this whole time I'm going through my process, I don't even know I'm dealing with mold toxicity, but it's in my body. My gut is getting worse and worse. I go through the whole functional doctor program. I can't take like almost every single supplement that they're giving me because it's causing my gut to be more inflamed. And I'm tweaking my diet. I'm literally eating the perfect diet that you could eat. And I noticed a little bit of improvements, like there was some slight improvements. And then at the very end of the last day of me working with that practice, my girlfriend got sick and then she passed it to me and then I got sick and it's like all my progress went out the window. Like wow, I was sick. It's like my gut got re-inflamed, my energy went super low. It's like none of that stuff even worked. It was like a big band-aid that I put on the problem and there was like a deeper root cause that was still in resonance with the mold toxicity and the, you know, the health issue, and it just came flaring back up. So at this point I'm like, oh my God, like this is getting scary. So I go to the hospital. I'm like, what's going on with my body? And they're like, we don't see anything. There's no showing of anything. At this point, I can't even eat. Like I'm barely able to eat anything. Like I'm starting to run out of foods that I can rely on for some sort of relief. At this point, every single thing that I am eating is hurting my gut. On a scale of 1 to 10, at that time, it was probably like an 8. Every time I ate, it was like an 8 out of 10 pain scale. Don't know what's going on. I'm confused. I'm thinking, is it my kidney? Is it this? Is it that? Is it this? I go to the hospital and they tell me, we don't see anything. You look like a young, healthy man. So I'm like, what the hell is going on? I go and see a primary care doctor, go through a whole process of doing sigmoidoscopy, colonoscopy, you know, gastro and whatever the hell, where they take tubes and put it down your body. They don't find anything. Except at one point, so this is the craziest thing, they don't find anything. Then I go back to the hospital again because I'm like, what is happening? Like something's not right with my body. And then I diagnosed myself. I'm like, I think I have a kidney infection. And that was not the case at all. Like it wasn't. But I went to a urgent care doctor at this time. So I had gone to the hospital several different times on my own. And then I went to this one walk-in urgent care clinic and I basically told the doctor, I think I have a kidney infection. Can you prescribe me something? And the guy was like, sure. And he prescribed me a kidney infection medication for UTIs, I think is what it was. And this was like a powerful medication. And I'm thinking that's what's going on with me. Like, I don't even understand what's happening. Like, I'm confused. So, but I'm at this point, I'm like panicking and I'm frantic. I'm like not understanding what's going on. I'm losing control. My identity is like shattering. This is all in 2022. So that's not, this is not too long ago. Like we're towards the end of 2024. But long story short, I take that medication and it makes me so much worse. Like it literally took me from like being an 8 out of 10 not feeling good to a 10 out of 10 not feeling good. And then at this point, I had to move from San Diego, California to go back to Florida to stay with my mom and my stepdad because I was so sick and I was afraid of what was going on in my body that I didn't feel like I could do it on my own, living in California and living in San Diego. Like it was getting to a point where it was too much. And my energy was getting really low. I wasn't eating that much at all. So my mom actually gave me the opportunity to stay with her and my stepdad. So I took it. And long story short, I went there. I stayed with them. My girlfriend went with me. We drove down. And I had this like, I had this random moment. I was drinking a coffee, actually. This is before I left to Florida. I was drinking a coffee. And then something in my right ear just like snapped and it went out. It's the craziest thing. But like the sound in my right ear muffled. And I could, it was like nothing happened. So you know that feeling when water gets in your ear and you can't hear anything? That happened randomly. It just click, boom, my ear was muffled. And then not only was my ear muffled, my nostril as well on that same side was muffled as well. And I'm like, or it was stuffed. It was like stuffed and this ear was muffled. And I'm like, what in the hell is happening? So now not only is my gut super inflamed, can I not eat that many foods? I was trying to drink an energy drink, but now my ear is like, I can't hear out of my ear anymore. So it's giving me this sensation of being imbalanced. And I, at this point, I'm starting to question, like, am I being attacked by certain types of energies? You know, for someone who's an occultist and works with spiritual energies and whatnot, like this is when all this stuff started surfacing for me. Am I being attacked by certain entities? Is something happening to me? Am I being cursed, etc.? And the reality of the situation is this was all trauma that was flooding through my body. So trauma was really trying to come through and process because I was doing a lot of deep workings with my unconscious and with, you know, myself in general, but I was resisting actually feeling those emotions because I didn't understand what that meant and why that was so important. But all my trauma was flooding through my nervous system and I was resisting it, and it was manifesting as these crazy symptoms and these crazy, you know, things that were happening on my body. So I'm like, what the heck? It just added a whole new layer to it, a whole new layer of confusion. So then I end up going back to Florida, staying with my mom and my stepdad, and I'm having all this trauma just flooding back at me, like childhood wounds type of trauma. Like my mom, I'm starting to see like the way that she is and the way that she's operating with my stepdad and how codependent she is. And it was just like this crazy experience of being in something you don't want to be in. And I'm just watching it and I'm like feeling like I have no other choice but to see it. So it was just a terrible experience. And I'm there with my girlfriend at the time, and my girlfriend, like, I'm starting to realize I don't think I'm really in resonance with her. Like, I don't know why I'm dating her. I don't know why we're together. This does not feel right for me. And I just felt also like she wasn't really there for me either. I felt like she didn't really care. Like she didn't know how to be nurturing. She didn't know how to be that supportive with what it was that I was going through. And I'm like wondering to myself, like, why am I with you? Why did we both come out here? And all this stuff is just starting to surface. And then I go through the whole medical system again, the primary care system in Florida this time. I see every doctor you could see. I do all the different things that you have to do to like figure out what's going on with your body. And at the very end of it, they actually diagnosed me with something called C. diff, which is a gut infection. It's called C. difficile. And it's a very serious gut bacteria infection. Like it's not a good thing. And the craziest thing is before, when I was doing the other doctors and working with all the other doctors, I didn't have any C. diff, But it was only until after I took the medication in San Diego for the urinary tract infection that I didn't have, that's when I developed that gut infection of C. diff. So C. diff is one of those things that kind of, it exists in all of our bodies, but it's usually dormant because we have healthy gut bacteria. So when I took that urinary tract infection medication, it destroyed all of my healthy gut bacteria, and it allowed room for this this potentially dangerous bacteria to kind of get out of control. And it was scary because it was getting to the point when, you know, I was using the restroom, there was blood in my stool. So I'm in Florida, I've got blood in my stool, and I can't eat foods, my gut is inflamed, my ear is clogged, my nose, I can't breathe out of my nose. At this point, I'm thinking I'm literally dying. I'm literally thinking that I have cancer and that I'm going to be diagnosed with cancer and that I'm gonna die. So I'm getting ready to kind of like embrace that. And that's scary, right? So I'm at this point, I'm also trying to do everything I can to heal my body. I'm doing ritualistic practices. I'm creating symbols. I'm doing invocations of energy. I'm sitting outside and I'm visualizing my body healing. I'm doing everything you think you can do to heal your body, eating like a perfect diet. As I said, like I'm trying everything and my body is getting worse and worse and worse and worse. My dad is like starting to call me and he's like, Jeremiah, like I want to support you through this process, etc. So he starts kind of supporting me a little bit with financially, because I'm spending so much money working with all these doctors. And then at a certain point, since it's not working, he then tells me, Jer, I think you just need to give your life to Christ. You have to give your life over to Christ. And I'm like, Dad, that's not something I resonate with. Like I don't need you to tell me that. I just want you to be a dad to me. And I said that to him, and then he just stopped supporting me. He just completely, okay, fine then. And he cuts me off. And I'm just like, oh, the pain was getting so crazy and all this trauma was just flooding right in front of my face. I felt like I was getting to a wall. I was being closed in on something that I didn't understand. And I was like, there was no room to escape, but just be in the pain. So at a certain point, my mom and my stepdad, the lease was ending that year. So I had to get my own apartment and I didn't even feel ready to do that. I was so sick. I just didn't even feel like I could do that, but I had to. So I went and I got my own apartment with my girlfriend. We lived in it and it was a really dark apartment. You know, it was just like, there was no sunlight. Like the way, for some reason, this apartment room, the way that it was located in the building, there was like no natural sunlight, which was obviously something I was in resonance with. It was just darkness. It was like the unconscious mind. Still, my body is hurting, everything. I start limiting my foods more and more and more. Like at this point, I'm literally only eating a shake of like an avocado, blueberry, and then like a couple strawberries. And that is what I, like every day, that's all I'm eating. So I'm literally probably taking in potentially less than 1,000 calories a day. I start losing weight so quickly. This is when I got down to 134 pounds. And this is like, you know, during this time as well, I was still making YouTube videos. I was still making content. I was still working with clients because that's something that, you know, I'm passionate about. It's something that's aligned with my purpose. And it's something that, you know, it was like the only thing that I really had energy to do. And then everything else outside of that, I had to just rest and give my body time to heal as it could. So no one really from the outside fully understood what I was going through internally. And I was kind of hiding that and I was concealing that because I think I felt afraid to be vulnerable and a little bit ashamed to share what it was that I was going through, because I think what I wanted to do was create an image of who I thought I was and who I think I am. And, you know, this kind of stuff can't and doesn't happen to me. But at the end of the day, it did. And I'm a human too. And trauma is something we all experience, and it manifests for us in different types of ways, and it definitely took its toll on me, for sure. So there was a lot that I was going through. Long story short, it gets to the point where I am, I'm living in this new apartment. I'm with my girlfriend, and I start drinking milk kefir because that was one of the only things that I felt like I could tolerate. And I start drinking a lot of milk kefir, like a lot of it, like so much of it, because I'm like trying to put calories back on my body, trying to gain weight again, etc. And I'm not eating really anything else, just drinking milk kefir from the market. And due to the high level of cholesterol, what it did is it started to manifest liver stones. So if you don't know what liver stones are, it's basically like gallstones that usually manifest in your gallbladder. But I manifested so many gallstones in my gallbladder that it started going into my liver. So my liver started getting clogged up with basically crystallized cholesterol. And it's like, think about like a hose tube with a bunch of stones in it and how the water is gonna have a harder time flowing. So the liver produces bile and the gallbladder squeezes bile out from it, and bile emulsifies fats. And it also is responsible, get this, bile is responsible for detoxing mold from the body. So now the one organ that I have that is meant to detox this mold that's in my body, which I don't even know I have in my body yet, is now also taking a toll and is now also not functioning at its full capacity. It's actually really struggling. So at this point, this is when things go to a whole nother level of hell, basically. This is in the very, 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 very beginning of 2023. I realize I can't keep drinking the milk kefir. So I'm still trying to heal my gut. I don't even know what's going on with my liver. I don't even know I have liver stones going on. I'm just feeling like shit. And the next thing you know, I'm trying a new modality of something. I'm like, I'm going to go on a juice fast. I'm only going to juice for like 30 days or 60 days. I was even willing to go for like 90 days of only juicing. So I started that. I started juicing. And on day number 7, I ended up juicing on accident moldy spinach. So there was spinach that was in my fridge that was sitting there for too long and I forgot about it. And I used it and I didn't see the mold on it, but it was old and it was moldy and I juiced it. And this is like on day 7. I remember I drank it and I'm not even kidding you. I almost died. I went into anaphylactic shock where I couldn't breathe. And my whole mind and psyche went into a whole nother realm. It went into a different dimension. I'm not kidding you when I say this. Mold is a fungus. Fungus is a mushroom. Okay, let me turn this down a little bit. So as I was saying, it's a fungus. So mushrooms, when you take mushrooms and then you go into a psychedelic trip in a psychedelic state, that's because it's a fungus that is having this psychedelic effect on your mind and your body and your spirit. I drank mold, which is the most dangerous form of fungus, that literally sent me into a psychedelic trip while the one organ in my body that's responsible for detoxing it naturally is also not operating at full function. So my entire lungs completely like constricted and I couldn't breathe. In that moment, I thought I was literally gonna die. Something happened in my intuition that told me to go to my cabinet, open it up, and in the cabinet, I had a thing of vitamin C. So I went to that and I took it. I took a high dose of vitamin C. I don't know why I knew to do this, but it was something intuitive inside of me that just said, do this. I went, I took a high dose of vitamin C, popped like 5 of them, and then slowly my lungs started opening up again. Now, the reason why that took place is because vitamin C is a natural antihistamine. And when I took in the mold, my body went into a autoimmune response, which is basically like a histamine response, where it basically starts protecting itself. And that's why it constricted my lungs so much. And I was experiencing that asthma. And the vitamin C helped to calm that back down and basically bring me more back to a neutral state. So that literally ended up saving my life. That intuitive, instinctual knowing to do that saved my life. If I didn't have that, I don't know if I would still be here. I'm sure that I'm sure there would be a way, something would have happened, but it was one of the scariest things. From that day forward, I was in a psychedelic state, a psychedelic trip. It was like I was tripping on mushrooms in a bad dream that you cannot get out of. This is at the very beginning of 2023, because I now just drank more mold into my body from the already existing mold. It is at this point where I'm at such a low point that I don't know what's going on. I'm getting to the point where I'm now accepting death. I'm like, I think I might die. And I'm spending my entire day laying on the bed, sitting with myself, just wondering why. What happened? What's going on? How do I change this? I'm not fully in acceptance yet. I'm not fully understanding trauma and how trauma is playing a role in this yet. I'm still kind of fighting the reason as to why is this happening? How do I control it? And how do I change it? But it was getting, there was so much pain in it. It was forcing me into self-acceptance. And I was literally connecting with the source. I mean, I remember laying on that bed, and feeling like I am dying, I am dissolving, and I'm about to transition into a different, like a different dimension, a different realm. And I was connecting with that energy. I mean, it was, I can't even explain to you. I honestly, I'll say this with confidence. I think if most of you experienced what I experienced in that, you probably would have just given up, in the sense of like people would off themselves in that type of experience. And I don't think, obviously, I don't say that in a way that's like, I don't think all of you would. I think most people would. I think there's a lot of you that would, you know, would have to go through that experience too, the same way that I did. What I'm basically saying is that I have never been taken to such a capacity in my life, and I've been through a lot of things in my life, and that was like one of the most intense things. So then what starts happening is I start working with another practitioner, a functional medicine practitioner, but this guy is different. He's basically my age, and I can connect with him at a different level. He actually reminds me a lot of parts of myself too. And he starts taking me through somatic work, which means connecting into the body and feeling what's going on. So I started doing somatic work with him over the phone, and slowly and surely trauma started coming up in my body that I started becoming more aware of. And at this point in time, the girlfriend that I was living with, she literally ended up leaving. She ended up leaving me. And at a time when I actually needed her the most, like I really needed support, and I needed someone to kind of help me kind of navigate, helping me make my food for the little food that I was eating, and just helping me kind of like do little things around the house, like the laundry and the dishes. Like I needed support. I did not have energy to do those things. And she ended up leaving me in that time when I needed someone. And it was so hurtful, and it was so sad, because we were together for basically 2.5 years, and I was there for her at a time when she was really going through the worst of it. And I helped her to navigate that and understand it. And when I was in that position, that was not reciprocated. I was abandoned. And that is what showed me that that was a decision that I made to go into a relationship with someone that didn't have capacity to fully love me the way that I needed. And I realized that that was a very codependent energy of me to do that. And it took me time to process that. But long story short, she leaves me. And it was crazy, because like I had bought her a golden ring like way back when we were first dating, like when I first asked her to be my girlfriend. And right before that happened, that golden ring that she would wear, it broke on her finger. A golden ring broke. Like I've never heard that happen before. It was a golden ring, and it snapped on her finger, like actual gold. I spent good money on it. And it somehow, it was kind of thin, like there was a thin type of gold, but it snapped. And that's still like crazy to believe. And that was symbolic to me as well. And then she ends up leaving. And that surfaced this huge abandonment wound for me, which is what I went through when my parents separated and my mom left my dad and she turned to alcohol and drugs. And my dad basically turned on me as if it was my fault that she left him. And it just surfaced all this trauma for me. And it gave me room to go into it, to process it, and to have to feel it. So then at that point, I realized, like, I don't even want to live in that apartment anymore. I don't know why I'm here. Like, my whole mindset shifted, like, after that separation. I'm like, what am I even doing? Like, why am I here right now? So I ended up, I was so sick, I had to go live with my mom and my stepdad again. But this time I'm not with my girlfriend. So she ends up flying out to California to stay with her dad, which was a relationship that she built with him through living with me. I kind of supported her in rekindling that relationship because she used to really hate her dad. And so she was able to heal some of that masculine energy in her life by being with me. And I'm happy for that. And I'm happy for her that she was able to do that. So she ended up moving back out with him, and I made sure she got her stuff and was able to get out there and everything. And I was done. I was done with that relationship. Like, there was no part of me that wanted to really, like, get back into it or reconnect in some way. Like, I just felt like that had reached its end point. And I was like, okay, that's done. I'm going to let this go now. And we were able to call each other and get closure and everything and then be done with it. And that was it. And, you know, that is what that is. So then I end up moving out to where I currently live, which is in Florida, in Vero Beach. And I'm now staying in a condo with my mom and my stepdad because I'm still very sick. Like, I don't have much energy to do basic things. And it's at this point where so much more of this trauma is coming to the surface. Once again, it's playing out between my mom and my stepdad. Like, it's showing me these similar patterns that I was used to in my past with my parents, my mom and my actual dad. And I'm seeing these things play out. And then my mom's, like, always abandoning me over and over. Like, she'll say something, it will trigger me, and I'll try to talk, and then she'll abandon, she'll, no, I don't. And then she slams the door and she leaves. Every time, over and over. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, this is too much. It's too much. And I'm so sick. I just didn't feel like I could even get out. Like, I'm having trouble breathing. I'm dealing with this mold toxicity. I have these liver stones in my body. I'm 130 pounds. You can literally look at my Instagram page. You could go to my YouTube videos during this time. Go to my YouTube videos from the end of 2022. And you're gonna see how skinny I was. Like, I was bones. I was 130 pounds. And I didn't have energy to do anything, really. So I was forced to just face this trauma and see it for what it is. And this is when I slowly started to realize, now I need to heal trauma. And I was very thankful because the environment over here in Vero Beach is it's a beautiful environment. So I'm no longer living in this dark this dark apartment with no natural sunlight. Now there's a lot of sunlight. It's right next to the ocean. It's like it's really a beautiful environment. And that felt really good to be able to experience that beauty from nature. But I slowly started understanding more and more about the trauma. And it took a long time for me to really grasp it. But it basically got to the point I was trying to use supplements to heal my body. And I eventually got to the point where I realized that what I was dealing with was mold toxicity. And this was through working with that one practitioner that was doing the somatic work with me. He said, I think you might have mold. And that word came up again. And I'm like, mold? Interesting. And then he told me about his journey with mold and how severe it was. And no one knew what was going on. And now I'm thinking, that's probably what I got. So I got tested for it. And sure enough, it came back with mold in my body to a pretty high level. And that was the reason why my gut was so inflamed. But I was still in the state that, okay, let me just change it. Let me fix it now. Let me take all these supplements and try to get the mold out of my body. But the reality is the mold was in my body because I was in energetic resonance for it. And there was emotions that I needed to release and process for me to be able to actually resolve the mold. So I went through a cycle of trying to take all these different supplements, and every supplement was hurting my gut more and more and more. And I was in this cycle for too long, months, trying to figure out what's the exact supplement, what's, how do I control this situation, how do I just change it, rather than just accepting where I was, understanding I'm dealing with mold toxicity, being thankful that I know that, and then being willing to connect to the energetic roots of why the mold is actually in my body. That's what I was resisting the most. I finally got to the point where I started surrendering more. And at this point, I ended up getting my own condo in Vero Beach, Florida, so I could be in my own healing space. This is where I currently live now. And it was at this point where I'm really starting to work through my trauma and I'm starting to accept it, because I don't have anything else to do. There's like nothing else to do but face this stuff now at this point in my life. And this is obviously a process and it takes time, and I'm understanding it more and more as time is going on, but I am starting to surrender to it. Like, I can't control it. I can't change it. And like, once again, there are no words to describe how painful and excruciatingly scary this whole process is and was, because it's like you wake up every day and you don't have energy to do anything but go into your trauma. It's like the only thing you can do, and you feel like if you don't do it, you literally might die. So going through that for months on end. But obviously in that, I mean, there's huge amounts of evolutionary changing that's taking place within myself. So I started coming into acceptance more and more and more, and I started letting go of the supplements. I basically was taking no supplements at this point. And naturally, as I was accepting it more, I was processing this immense amount of pain in my body and grief. Like, there was so much sadness and grief in my system from what I went through in the past that I didn't even know was there. I didn't even know how serious it was. And I'm just sitting here and I'm crying and I'm letting stuff come out. And then I literally, like, there's times where my actual inner child is manifesting in front of me, like a physical embodiment, but not actually. It's like, it looks like it, but it's not. It's an energetic manifestation of my own inner child that's standing in front of me. And I'm just like hugging it. And I'm loving this, you know, this version of me. It makes me emotional just speaking about it. And I'm connecting with some of the memories and some of the pain that I went through with my inner child. And it's bringing me back to these memories of when my family separated and different things that I went through with my mom and my dad and certain types of friends and different decisions that I made, you know, during that time because I was hurt. And it's connecting me with all of this, and I'm just feeling it and I'm processing it on a, you know, on a consistent basis. And the more that I was releasing emotions, I'm not kidding you, the more I was energetically resonating with different things that were supporting my gut. So I ended up kind of gravitating towards a certain way of eating where I was putting my food into crock pots and I was cooking it so that it would get really soft. And at this point, I'm introducing more food back into my diet. So I'm eating vegetables and I'm eating chicken. And I was putting fat on the chicken too, so I could start taking in calories again because I needed them. So long story short, my food is cooked really soft, but it was still hurting my gut, but it was not as bad as what, you know, other ways I was eating was. So I just accepted the pain that was there and I had a consistent plan and I just focused on the emotions from that point forward. I was every single day I cooked my food in that crock pot, fresh vegetables and then chicken. And that was it. And I stayed consistent with that for months and processed the emotions and forgot about supplements. And literally, I'm not kidding you, within time, my gut started getting better and better and better to the point that it was completely healed. Okay, literally to the point that there was no more reactions taking place. And literally, I can eat now anything I want and not have any problems going on in my gut. And that is what showed me how powerful trauma is. And when you release trauma and you come into acceptance with where you actually are and you face those things inside of your system, that's what actually heals your system. That's what actually changes your life for the better. And through this whole process as well, you can imagine There are many different types of friendships and relationships that are dissolving out of my life that I no longer resonate with. I'm not attaching to them because I don't have any energy to, and I'm so sensitive to other people too. Like, I'm feeling energy and I'm realizing more about what I want. And then I'm also bringing in healthier relationships too during this time. And I'm not, you know, keep in mind, I'm not perfect either at this time. There's still a lot going on in my system and there's a lot of stuff that I'm learning. And I still, you know, was processing some different types of fragmentation in my system with my sense of self and what's going on there. But I was going into enough of that core of myself and releasing these repressed energies to literally heal my physical symptom and actually get the mold out of my body to the point where I didn't have that symptom. And that was huge. So this was my whole journey working with mold toxicity. And mold ended up becoming one of the biggest valuable teachers that I have ever experienced in my entire life. And remember, this lasted for a little bit over 2 years. So this is a long time of being in severe pain and suffering to the point where it's like every day you don't know if you're gonna live. But it put me through a revolution of my consciousness and the connectedness of all of us truly and what actually matters and, you know, who I truly am and what I'm here to do. This was a revolutionization of my beingness. And this is why there has been such a drastic shift in regards to who I am as a person and what it is that I now teach in regards to my public channel from the old me. The old me was talking all about the Rothschilds and using the occult to kind of take over the world in certain ways and everything. And this version of me now is much more integrated and understands that that was a trauma response. And that was me still trying to fight the world, you know, fighting my father and rebelling against my mother. And realizing that there's so much more to life, you know, just being in the present moment and being able to be vulnerable and have emotions and working on these, you know, unhealthy coping mechanisms that we all have. Like for me, working on those things and coming off of alcohol, coming off of kratom, coming off of caffeine, you know, and treating myself in a much more healthy way with nurturing my body with healthier whole foods and drinking, you know, staying hydrated with water and giving myself time to feel my feelings. Like this combination of things is so simple, but this little thing has changed and transformed so much in my life and in my beingness. And it's like literally how I'm going to keep moving forward with my life. Not saying that I'm perfect. You know, there's definitely times where I kind of slip into things. Sometimes I get into a cycle that I recognize from the past. And I'm like, okay, I'm in this cycle. I don't want to do that again. So let me have acceptance for this cycle and let me understand it for what it is as a protective response. And then let me release it and return back to my center and realize like I can move forward and I can, you know, become a new version of myself. So once again, I share all of this with you so that those of you that are interested in hearing about my experience with this, now you have an understanding. And for any of you that are dealing with mold toxicity, now you can maybe understand a little bit more depth to the power of mold and what mold is really here to do as a teacher for you and how it's rooted in energy. It's rooted in your emotion. So don't get caught up in trying to put a Band-Aid on something that actually needs a root cause healing to it. So that is the message that I have for all of you. So if you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you let me know in the comments. Let me know if you resonate with it. Let me know if there's something that you learned from this. I would love to hear your personal perspective. Now also hit the thumbs up button. That lets me know that you enjoyed the video. Hit the notification bell and get notified whenever I'm posting this content, because I'm literally posting this content every single day and it's tons of valuable stuff that's coming out. All right, drop down into the subscribe button. Make sure you're subscribing to the channel because that's gonna further connect you to everything. And I encourage you to copy and paste this link and send it to someone that you feel like needs to hear this, because there's probably someone out there that you know that really might be going through something like this. you would never guess. So go ahead and send it to someone. It could help shift their perspective on things. Now, go ahead and check out my Patreon. That's the first link in the description below. This is going to give you access to a whole bunch of exclusive content, and I have collection sections that goes really deep into understanding trauma and the nervous system, which is going to be really helpful for going through deep healing within the body. Then I have a whole bunch of other types of content as well, all accessible to you as a Patreon member. Tier 3 and 4 is very unique. It's a ritual service from me to you, and it's an energetic transfer that I perform to support you through this process of going really deep into your unconscious mind to help surface these things so that you can face them with acceptance and with compassion so that you can integrate these energies and come into more alignment with who you actually are and turn on this dormant capability within your unconscious. Okay, it's a very powerful ritual service, and I'm very passionate about it. This is something that I've been doing for about 4 years now. And I'm led to do this because it does support the people that are meant to receive it. So with that being said, all that's the first link. Second link is where you can book a one-on-one call or mentorships. I would love to be able to work with you in that way. Also in the second link, you can book a tarot card reading with Alexia. She's a very gifted tarot card reader. Third link is going to be the Lucifer's Foundation course. This is a whole course that gives you step-by-step processes to follow to develop a relationship with the energy of the light bearer. Fourth link is my YouTube memberships. I would love to have you in the Universal Mastery family. And the fifth link is my book recommendations for you, for those of you that are getting into the occult and want some books to follow. With that being said, this is going to wrap it up. I appreciate all of you very, very much. And I hope you all have an amazing rest of the day or night, wherever you are. And I will see you in the next video. Peace.